We'll discuss about the second chapter, that is physical quantities and measurement. In this chapter we will discuss about measurement of density, flotation and sinking. Okay, so what is density actually? The mass per unit volume of a substance is called its density. So that means the mass per unit volume of a substance is its density. So if we consider an object has mass m and the volume of it is v, then the volume v has mass m. So unit the mass of unit volume is equals to m by v, is not it? And we know that according to the definition of density, the mass per unit volume is the density. So we can say that density is mass by volume. So density equals to mass by volume. Clear? So now we will discuss about units of density. So what is units of what are the units of density? In CGS system, we know that the unit of mass is gram and the unit of volume is semi cube or centimeter cube or cubic centimeter, isn't it? So we can say that in CGS system the unit of density is gram per semi cube, isn't it? And in SI system the unit of mass is kg and the unit of volume is meter cube or cubic meter. So the in SI system the density the unit of density is kg per meter cube. Okay, that means kilogram per meter cube actually. Okay, so what is the relation between kg per meter cube and gram per semi cube? Okay, so we know that 1 kg per meter cube or 1 kg meter to the power minus 3 means 1 kg by 1 meter cube, isn't it? So 1 kg means we know that 1000 gram, and 1 meter cube means 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter, that means 100 semi into 100 semi into 100 semi, so 100 semi cube. So 1000 gram by 100 into 100 into 100 means 100000 semi cube. So from this we can conclude that 1 by 1000 gram per semi cube. So 1 kg per meter cube means 10 to the power minus 3 gram per semi cube, or we can say that 1 gram per semi cube means 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. Okay, so it is a list of density of some substances. Solid, suppose cork has density 0.25 gram per semi cube. In kg per meter cube its density is 250. Okay, so in case of liquid, alcohol has density 0.78 gram per semi cube or 780 kg per meter cube. Okay, density of determination of density of a solid by using a measuring cylinder. So how we can measure a density of a solid? We know that the density of a solid, that means to determine the density of a solid, we need its mass and volume. We know that the density is mass, density is equals to mass by volume. So we can calculate the mass of the solid by using a physical balance, isn't it? But how we can calculate its volume? So if we take a measuring cylinder, so at first we need to take a measuring cylinder, okay? And if we fill the measuring cylinder by water, and suppose the water level is 50 here, okay? So that means the volume of the water is 50 semi cube, okay? Now we need to tie the given solid to a fine thread, okay? And if we lower it gently in the measuring cylinder, then what will happen? The water level will rise, is not it? And here now the water level is 75, that means the volume is now 75 centimeter cube. Now we can calculate the volume of the solid by subtracting the initial volume from the final volume. Okay, so the volume of the solid is 75 semi cube minus 50 semi cube, that means 25 semi cube. After calculating the volume, if we divide its mass by volume, then we will get its density. So suppose the mass is m and the volume is 25, so the density will be 5 m by 25 gram per semi cube. Okay, so suppose the mass is 50 gram and volume is 25 semi cube, so the density will be 50 by 25 gram per semi cube, that means 2 gram per semi cube. Thus we can determine the density of a solid. Okay, now another method is that measurement of density of irregular solid using Eureka can. So this is a Eureka can, or we can say that it is a overflow jar also. Okay, so at first we need to fill the ureca can or the overflow jar with water. Okay, so till the water is at the point of overflowing, that means this point. Okay, and we also need to place a measuring cylinder here. Okay, so what we need to do first, so we need to tie the solid to a fine thread. Okay, and then we need to lower it gently in the ureca can or the overflow jar. Okay, then what will happen, the solid displaces water, is not it, and the water will flow out from the spout into the measuring cylinder. Okay, so then we need to record the volume of water overflown. Okay, and this volume is equals to the volume of the solid. Okay, so now, and if we calculate the mass of the solid by using a physical balance, then if we divide the mass by volume, then we will get the density. Now, variation of density of liquids and gases with temperature. We all know that all forms of matter, that means solids, liquids and gas, expand on heating and contract on cooling. But in case of solid, with the rise in temperature, the expansion is negligible. Okay, so the volume also, the change of volume of solid is also negligible. So we can say that the density is mass by volume and the mass remains constant. So as the change of volume is also negligible and mass is constant, so the change of density is also negligible in case of solids. But in case of liquids and gases, the expansion with rise in temperature is very much high. So the change in volume is also very large, is not it? But in case of liquid and gas, what will happen? The mass will remain constant. But as on heating, the volume, the change of volume is very much high. So we can say that we know that the density is equal to mass by volume. So as the volume increases, but the mass remains constant, so the density will decrease, is not it? Because D equals to m by V. So if m constant but the V increases, then what will happen? The density will increase, decrease, is not it? Because D is inversely proportional to V. Okay, that means with increase of volume, the density decreases. With increase in volume, the density decreases. Okay, so this is example. If a liquid X has a volume 100 semi-cube and mass 150 gram at 0 degree centigrade, and on heating its volume at 100 degree centigrade is 110 semi-cube, then what is the variation in density? We know that the density at 0 degree centigrade is mass by volume, so 150 by 100, that means 1.5 gram per semi-cube. But in case of 100 degree centigrade temperature, the mass by volume is, mass remains constant, we know that, so 150 by the volume is now 110 semi-cube. So 150 by 110 semi-cube, that means 1.36 gram per semi-cube. So with rise in temperature, the density decreases. Okay, now we will discuss about consequence of change in density of liquid in with temperature. So if we know that if we heat a liquid in a beaker, so what will happen? Then the water close to the bottom of the beaker will at first expand, because is not it, because it is nearest to the that means source of heat, is not it? So it will expand first. So then what will happen? Due to the expansion, its density will decrease. So as it becomes lighter, it will rise up, is not it? And to fulfill the empty space, the cold and dense water from the upper region will flow down, is not it? Will flow down towards the bottom of the beaker, is not it? Then what will happen? Then it will expand, is not it? Thus, a sort of current is set up in water, and this current produced in the water is called convection current. Okay, and this convection current is responsible for heating a liquid. Okay, now consequences. So now we will discuss about consequences of change in density of gases with temperature. So in case of burning upward, what will happen? The air nearer to the source of heat, on getting heat, will expand, is not it? And due to its expansion, what will happen? The density will decrease, and due to the decrease in density, it will become lighter and it will rise up, and after that to fulfill the empty space, the cold and that means dense air will flow towards the source of heat, isn't it? And this is actually the convection, and this convection is actually responsible for the formation of weather, and the land and the sea breeze, the monsoon is formed in nature because of the convection of currents. Okay, now we will discuss about land breeze and sea breeze. So what is sea breeze? A sea breeze is the wind which blows from the side of the sea towards the land during daytime. So why it happens? Due to the difference in air pressure actually. Okay, so we know that as the sun rises and shines equally on the surface of the land as well as sea, the land gets heated up rapidly as compared to sea water, isn't it? So what will happen? The air above the land gets warm and less dense, isn't it? Because it will expand more, isn't it? So this air becomes lighter and it causes a dropping in the air pressure, isn't it? And to make up for this drop in air pressure, the cool air from the sea starts blowing towards the land. So this is actually the sea breeze.